I'm okay.
Sorry?
I see you in the snow.
Yeah. We gotta get used to it, right? We're gonna get, it's gonna come.
Thank you.
range as well for anybody that wants to pick it up that way. But we give God praise for everything He has done, especially with everything that is going on in our state, our communities, surrounding communities, where some of our sister churches in Erie County have closed back down. And I keep saying we're getting closer and closer to that as well. We're being prayerful and we still trust God. Amen. This is Thanksgiving weekend, or leading up to Thanksgiving weekend. And so we have much to be grateful for. Amen. Excuse me for it. Y'all know every week is a problem with something. We even have a new camera that worked wonderfully yesterday and then acted up this morning for whatever reason. That's why we have two different things set up right now, so that we can still share on Facebook, on the Trinity Facebook page, on my personal Facebook page, also on YouTube. For those that are watching at home, and also for those that share the DVDs that we also give. I don't know if anybody expect for it to rain or snow today. Well, I think it was in the forecast, but I thought it was just going to be just a little bit, you know. And I wanted to start crying. I wanted to start crying. Thank God for even the snow. How about y'all? Even the snow. Still trying to set up a few more things here, right? I think that we're just about set. Just about set. Amen. So we're happy to see you who are here. We're happy to see our mayor today. Mayor Obama with us. Amen. And for sharing with us. Thank God again for my wife. We thank God for our nurse, Tamika, who takes our temperature and asks all pertinent questions. And we want them, anybody that watches us, to know that we're following every rule that we can follow. Amen. We thank God for you. Follow those rules as well. Amen. Amen. We will not hold you long. I don't think. Amen. We're trying to stay within the hour. Psalms 33. Psalms 33. For you who have your phones or whatever, since we have no papers or Bibles. Psalms 33 says, "Rejoice in the Lord, O ye righteous, for praise is commonly for the upright. Praise the Lord of heart. Sing unto him with the psaltery, and an instrument of 10 strings. Sing unto him a new song. Play skillfully with a loud noise. For the word of the Lord is right, and all his works are done in truth. He loveth righteousness and judgment, and the earth is full of the goodness of the Lord." May God add his richest blessing to the reading and to the hearing of his word. And the church said, amen. Amen. Father, in the name of Jesus, we come and we thank you for this day. We thank you for blessing us to be here today. We thank you for all that you have done with us and for us. We thank you, God, for this community of believers that share on today. Pray that you would bless us. We thank you for this weekend as we prepare for Thanksgiving. And though much has happened on this year, many of us have suffered loss. Many of us have questioned the path of where we may be going. But we thank you for your guidance. We thank you for your love and your protection. God, we pray that you would bless this city. Bless our leadership, Pastor. Bless our mayor. Pray that you bless our government, God. Lord, we need you in our national government right now. We pray, God, for your intervention. We know that your will will be done, contrary to what others may say. And, oh God, we come and we give you the praise. And we give you the glory. Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, amen.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Praise the Lord, everybody. While we're here, we might as well praise the Lord. Hallelujah. This is the day that the Lord has made. We shall rejoice and be glad in it. In spite of the snow, we still here and we have come out to give God the praise, the honor, and the glory. Hallelujah. So good to see all of you. Can we just honor our pastor on today? Hallelujah. And give it up for our mayor. Hallelujah. Mayor is standing on. He's also my boss. He's in here to leave today. Amen. Hallelujah. We're just going to pray and ask God to cover the nation, cover the country, cover this land. We are so, so in need of prayer. Hallelujah. We were out yesterday trying to get out early, and my husband had a taste for something to eat. So we went to the store, and there were so, so many people in the store. I'm a strong person anyway. I pray. I encourage people. I'm there. I try to give advice. God is good. But Lord and behold, you must truly have had a panic attack yesterday. I had a panic attack in the store. My husband had to grab me. Let's go. Let's get out of here. Because all the people from Erie County is coming over here to Niagara County. So I said, Lord, help me. I got in the car. I was spraying myself. He opened up the trunk. He was spraying me. I walked out of the house. I took everything off. So I said, God, help me. But I'm just saying, I never had in my life experienced a panic attack until I had one yesterday. So not only am I praying for you, but I need you people of God to pray for me. Hallelujah. So good to see all of you who are watching and to those who are in the parking lot. We're just going to look to the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we thank you in the name of Jesus for being such a good, good God. We thank you, oh God, that all power belongs to you. We thank you, oh God, that in the midst of everything that is going on, you are still in control. There is nothing that is taking you by surprise, oh God. You just love us anyhow. You protect us anyhow, God, in the midst of confusion and chaos. But God, we know that you are not the author of confusion nor chaos, oh God. So while people are acting crazy, God, we know that we have an anchor in you. So God, we come for no other reason today but to give you the praise, the honor, and the glory. God, we thank you for your hand of protection. God, we know that you are working even when we don't see it. God, you are working. Even though we don't feel it, we know that you are working. God, we know that you are a way maker still. We know that you are a promise keeper still. We know that you are a healer still. We know that you are a deliverer still. So God, in this upcoming week of Thanksgiving, God, we dare not eat food without giving you the praise, the honor, and the glory first. Because even in the pandemic, God, we are still able to eat. God, we still have a roof over our head, oh God. We still can wash ourselves and feed ourselves. We still can drive, oh God. We still can put two nickels together, oh God, to make a dime. So Father, we thank you for being our provider. God, we thank you for being Jehovah Jireh in our life in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we thank you for Jesus. We thank you for salvation. We thank you for the Holy Spirit. Now, oh God, if we have entered into your house any kind of way other than a praise way, we ask for forgiveness in the name of Jesus. Somebody came out in the snow, God, in the sleet, God, in the rain, God, to say no matter what, I'm going to praise you today. Oh! in the name of Jesus, behind prison walls. There's somebody who wants to know you, oh God. So touch right now in the name of Jesus. Those who are traveling, come touch in the name of Jesus. Give them traveling grace and mercy. So Father, we thank you for all things in the name of Jesus. Now, God, let your mantle of peace rest upon me, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Praise the honor and the glory. Come on, church.
didn't say that. Try to encourage. Someone says some encourages the encourager. That just falls in. That fell, that's good. But who encourages the encourager? And so we just keep trusting in God. We keep believing that God has all power in His hand. How many of y'all believe that today? That's all we got to stand on today, is that faith in God, trusting in God. Amen. So we come and we trust Him, we believe Him, we thank Him, even in this period of time. And I know that there's some people that have said, what do we have to be thankful for? What do we have to be thankful for? There are some people that can say in this congregation that my child passed away and I wasn't even able to have a proper burial for them. Some people went from the hospital right to the crematorium. And yet, and we have said that when this is all over, we'll have a proper burial. But yet, we don't know when this is all over yet. Thank God for news about the vaccine, but I don't know if I'm going to be one of the first ones. I don't know. I'm going to let y'all try it first. And then y'all let me know how it is. Praise God. Thank God for that. I'm trying not to watch the news. And find myself Googling Trump every morning just to see what's going on with the news. And saw this morning they asked for a third recount in Georgia. And some people just like to watch themselves lose, I guess. So, and it's crazy. Crazy, this world that we call a democracy. And so I try not to really say any much, be down or anything, because this is Thanksgiving week. And in the midst of it all, in the midst of COVID, in the midst of all these other things, and it just, a lot of people passed. My first death this year, my best friend died in February before COVID. Then I've had three other friends that were close to me pass away. Not only because of COVID, heart attacks and other things. And I've had a lot, I can't even count my hand the people that I know that have passed away. Some of y'all know that we were living in the New York City area, and it was like every day somebody was passing every week, and still even now, every week it seems like somebody has gone. I've been devastated at people that have passed away. Nicole, I still get angry about Devontae. I get so angry about that. Gifted musician that left us. And so, what do you say in the midst of all of that? All you can say still is, Lord, I thank you. Lord, I thank you. What else can you say? Because God gave you one more opportunity to be here. If you're here, you're blessed today. If you're here, you're blessed. I just wanted to share these words with you from 1 Chronicles 16 and 34. And again, when you play by ear, I'm going to ask, because I always say, if you can, if you don't, if you miss it, if you're late, it's okay. If you don't RSVP, you still can come. As long as I'm within the numbers I needed, I want to stay 100. But if you let us RSVP, at least we know that you're coming. We'll have some type of list. We keep a list of everybody that's here. And I appreciate those that even park in the parking lot because they just want to be close. Amen. People, why do they sit in the car? They just want to be close. You got to understand. You miss the fellowship. We were in the parking lot all summer. And Stacy, we even have a winter parking lot. No, a winter. Yeah, we even have Santa Claus out there. Amen. Jesus and Santa Claus. Bless the Lord. First Chronicles 16 and 34. My wife's going to say, hurry up, be quiet, let's go home. First Chronicles 16 and 34. Amen. It says, oh, give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his steadfast love endures forever. Oh, give thanks. Tell somebody, give thanks today. Give thanks today. Oh, give thanks today. We know that God is worthy, amen, to be praised. Everything, my brothers and sisters, good in your life, the Bible tells us, comes from God. In James chapter 1, verse 17, that's what it tells us. Everything good in your life comes from God. And we'll grow closer to God when we understand this truth and build our lives around it. There is something about giving thanks. There's something unique about giving thanks. But I've learned that to give thanks, you have to make it a daily habit. You have to not only make it a daily habit, but you must develop these habits. And when you develop these habits, they can help us to become more thankful. I'm sure you already know that being thankful is a learning process, because everybody is not thankful. Come on and help me there today, church. Everybody's not thankful. Everybody knows that there are some children that you have blessed that because their parents didn't teach them that they didn't know how to say thank you. There's some people that you have helped along this way. And many of us know this, I'm sure Mary knows this, that are ungrateful even after all the help that you give them. You would think that they would act differently towards you. But there is something about giving thanks. Regular practice giving thanks. We should make a habit of expressing gratitude. You do understand what people do for you, they don't have to do. Somebody ought to say amen. I'm going to say that again. You should make a habit of expressing gratitude. Thankfulness rather than criticism should be our default position. And when you see something good in your life, and I'm going to even put it a little bit further, that if you see something good in somebody else's life, amen, you ought to say thank you. Don't be jealous. Don't hold back and think, why did I get that? But understand that the same God that blessed them is able to bless you as well. Anybody in here today, I want to know, are you grateful for what you have? Are you grateful for what has happened in your life? Well, if you are grateful, then you ought to thank God for it. I know that every once in a while we complain occasionally, amen. Church folks like to complain all the time. We y'all ain't say amen to that one. We all complain occasionally, but practice responding to your own complaining by finding things to be thankful for is the best habit. This helps us to rewire our brain to be as proficient at recognizing the good in your life as you are at identifying the bad. And can I tell somebody here that no matter what is going on in your life, no matter how bad it might seem or appear, that you still have something to be grateful about? Do I have any witnesses here? I said you have something to be grateful about. The fact that you woke up and was able to complain, you ought to be thankful. You should say, oh God, thank you that I still can complain, but I still have the mind to think, amen. But I'm going to say it again, you have something to be grateful for. Express gratitude regardless of your situation. The Apostle Paul tells us in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 and verse 18 to give thanks in all circumstances because God wills it. Why does God will it? We never see the full picture. We can't look at every situation and clearly understand why it's happening. We can only know God is at work in those situations and that God is working them out for the good in his glory. Amen. That's what Romans 8 and 28 says. For we know that all things work together for the good of them that love God. Y'all know the rest of that? According to his purpose. So my brothers and sisters, regardless of what's happening, we can thank God for his presence. We can thank God knowing that even though we may not be able to see the end, we believe that God is working it out. Do I have some witnesses here? That's why some of y'all every day, I said this, I said, I want to talk about it, but y'all get upset and watching Trump on TV and wondering, why is he doing this? You know what? I turn off the TV, I don't even worry about it no more, because it's in God's hand. And no matter what happens, God is still in control. Whatever you're going through in your life, whatever's happening, whatever's, I don't care what the doctor says, I don't care what the lawyer says, I don't care what the judge says, I don't care what your neighbor says or your co-worker says, everybody got something to say. But when it comes down to the nitty-gritty, you must understand God still has you in his hand, and God will and God can take care of it. I know I have some witnesses here. I tell you today, and I'm not going to be wrong, I said that he is redeeming the situation and sustaining us through it. Amen. We ourselves may be focusing solely on that situation, but God says, can you hold out and see what the end is going to be? There's somebody in here, you had to hold out, you had to wait on God. You didn't know how your circumstances were going to be, but guess what? You can say right where you are today, I'm still here by the grace of God. I have some still here folks here. You know what you've been through. You know what you've had to encounter. You know what folks have said about you. You know how folks have done you wrong. You know how things have not always gone your way. But now when you look back over your life and you see where you are right now, you can say, thank God I'm here by the grace of God. There was some folks that tried to kill me. There was some that tried to steal my joy. But guess what? I still got joy. I still got happiness. I still have peace within. I got something that man can't take from me because they didn't give it to me in the first place. Amen. So I want to say to you today, amen. Give God the praise. Give God the thanks. Amen. We can thank God because God promised us, Stacy, that he was going to be with us irregardless. He says, I'm with you. I'm with you. I'm with you. You might not be able to see me, but I'm with you. He said, Lord, I'll be with you even until the end of this age. Now, I want you to know, as I close, he's redeeming, amen, the situation. He's sustaining us through it. On our own, we focus on the current situation, but we can rise above the situation when we purposely look for what God is doing in the middle of it. There's a theologian by the name of A.W. Tozer who says, perhaps it takes a pure faith and praise, amen, and faith to praise God for unrealized blessings than for those who we once enjoyed and those we enjoy now. And what he was saying is, that don't just praise God for your blessings now. Don't just praise God for what you went through and what he got you through. But you ought to start praising God for stuff you don't even know about that's about to happen. I can praise God because I know that when it's all over, he's going to fix it for me. Praise God when all is well. But praise God, as he says, when things go bad. You want to drive yourself crazy? Have a smile on your face when things are going.
wrong. You want to get folks angry? Walk with your head up when they think you ought to walk with your head down. You want to get folks crazy? Laugh! Come on and help me here. Laugh if you laughing at them, but you're laughing about your situation. Can I get somebody to help me here? Laugh! I'm going to tell somebody to laugh today. Be happy. Have some joy. Can I get some with you? If things go wrong, I'm going to give you a steak. Come on and help me here. I'm going to my best restaurant. With things go wrong, I'm going to dress up anyway. Can I get some witnesses here? I might, y'all know me, I might go get some brand new shoes. Can I get some witnesses? But I'm going to look good. I'm going to smell good. Because I'm not here because of what you've done. But I'm here because of what God has done in my life.
I'm done. I'm done. So I'm going to praise God. I'm going to praise God. I've got so much to praise Him for. I got so much to praise Him for. And I'm going to make gratitude a part of my interaction with everybody that I come in contact with. I'm still going to bless you if you don't want to bless me. I'm still going to speak to you if you don't want to speak to me. I'm still, come on and help me here, going to be myself, amen. And I'm going to get strength from my praise. Come on, y'all. I'm going to get strength from being grateful with gratitude. I'm going to be grateful. I'm going to say thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. I've learned, let me tell you, I'm closer. I've learned to be thankful over the little things. I used to be thankful over the big things. Can I get with it? But now I'm thankful over the little things. I wish I had somebody here. If I got a penny on the ground, I'm thankful. Can I get some with it? I'm thankful in the midst of everything now. I don't know if you know this, Bear, but since I know we're about the same age, but since arthritis has showed up, come on and help me here. Pain in my body, come on. Take care of the memory that don't act. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about. You tell me your telephone number, and I can't remember it after you told me. You ask me, I see some of y'all out there, like, oh, Lord, what's their name? I forgot that. Can I get away? And don't y'all leave your car in the parking lot somewhere and see if you're going to remember it because you're out here trying to beat your. All these things are happening in life. Things are not what they used to be, but I stop by and say, I'm still grateful. Why am I grateful? Because I still can feel the pain. I feel the aches. Why am I grateful? Because at least I know I'm not that crazy. I just can't remember at that time. Why? Because I'm not 6 feet under. I'm still rising. Still got another day to tell God, thank you for what you've done for me. So I don't know about y'all, but let me tell you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. God gives thanks unto the Lord. Thank you for what you do. Somebody said if you have to say thank you, I mean, like, thank you. Just sometimes you ought to stand and say thank you. So, sometimes just stand in the room by yourself and say thank you. Drive down the street and say thank you. But sometimes just say, what are you thinking? I'm just not. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Something about thank you. Thank you. Thank you. When I look at my life, thank you. When I look where I come from, thank you. When I look at what I have, thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. I don't care about that. I say no. Thank you, Gary. Amen. For sticking with you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. For my friends that are still my friends. Amen. You didn't have to be my friend, but thank you. 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 Thank you for everything that you have done. Thank you. Can somebody help me say thank you? Thank you. Come on. Thank you. Thank you. That's all I want you to say. Thank you. Thank you for everything.
said, thank you. Thank you. And thank you. Lord, we thank you for what you have done. Thank you for all that you have done. Thank you for your praises. And we thank you for what you have given us. We give you the praise for all that you've done for us. Pray, God, for you to stay with us and guide us. Keep us within your care. No, God, we'll be so careful when you praise and glory. Bless your people during this holiday. Help them to continue to be safe. Help them continue to be safe. Help them continue to be safe. Yellow, orange, red, clear, whatever it is, I lie in your hand. We give you the praise and the glory. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said amen. God bless you all. Thank you today for sharing with us. And as always, we pray God bless upon you. Have a happy Thanksgiving. The Lord be with you is our deepest prayer. Our deepest prayer. Our deepest prayer. Amen. Anything you need to say before we go? Thank you, Mary, for coming to share with us. Lord be with you. Be dismissed in Jesus' name.
one. I told you I already had.
Oh, okay.
But I was looking for a winner. You know what I mean? They like this. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm.